गुड मॉर्निंग रिस्पेक्टेड सर एंड ऑल माई डियर फ्रेंड्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू अवर डिपार्टमेंट फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग सच अ नाइस प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द असाइनमेंट नंबर 4 ऑफ द IWT सब्जेक्ट. दिस इज द असाइनमेंट नंबर 4 ऑफ द IWT सब्जेक्ट. माई नेम इज आदित्य मानकर, रोल नंबर 28. Our topic name is Unit Operations and Unit Processes. First of all, we will go for the introduction. The various methods used in treating industrial wastewater are identical to those used in treating domestic sewage. However, the difference between the two modes of treatment arises because first, a very high degree of variability in the quality of industrial waste compared to the domestic sewage. Means in industrial waste there are different types of pollutants and in domestic sewage there are different types of pollutants. So there is high degree of variability between the two. Second, large variations in the flow rates of industrial wastes. And third, the presence of hazardous or toxic pollutants in some industrial wastes. In terms of population equivalent, industrial wastewater is usually a few times stronger than an equal volume of domestic sewage. Means in the industrial waste, there is more concentration of pollutants than the domestic sewage. In view of the possible presence of hazardous or toxic pollutants, it becomes necessary to provide adequate preliminary treatment to an industrial wastewater before subjecting it to the further treatment. This is achieved by employing various unit operations and unit processes. Unit operations are those in which physical forces are employed to purify wastewater. Some of the important unit operations are screening, sedimentation, rotation, filtration, mixing, equalization, flow proportioning, drying, incineration, freezing, foaming, dialysis, osmosis, adsorption, gas transfers, filtration, etc. So in unit operations, the chemical reactions does not take place. Only physical forces are employed to purify the wastewater. Second unit is unit processes. Unit processes are those in which chemical and or biological forces are used to purify wastewater. Example, pH correction, coagulation, oxidation, deduction, disinfection, aerobic and anaerobic biological treatment. These are going to be explained further. It is rarely adequate to apply only unit operations or only unit processes to an industrial wastewater. To obtain an effluent fit for the discharge to the environment. So we have to apply both the unit process, unit operations and unit process so that we get effluent fit for the discharge to the environment. Therefore, based on laboratory scale studies and our pilot plant studies, a proper choice of unit operations and unit processes is made, and this is arranged in a logical sequence to give an acceptable treatment scheme. A brief description of the various unit operations and processes and their application in industrial waste treatment is given below. So, this is the this is the diagram of the waste treatment levels. So in preliminary treatments, the removal of organic matter takes place by physical methods. In primary method, removal of suspended solids takes place by using both physical and chemical methods. In secondary treatment, removal of organic matter takes place by biological method. In tertiary or advanced method, removal of pathogens and nutrients takes place by chemical, photochemical, biological methods. See, this is the flow diagram of the wastewater treatment plant. So we can see that in primary treatment, mostly the unit operations are used, and in secondary treatment, unit processes are used. In primary treatment, the sewage enters the screens. From the screens, big particles gets removed. So we will first go for the screening process. Screening is done to remove type of the unit operation. The screening is done to remove large suspended and floating solids from wastewater in order to protect pumps, pipes and walls from clogging and damage. Example, rags and pieces of cloth from cotton textile waste, fine fibers from woolen mills, spent tan bark from vegetable tanning process, leather trimmings from the leather processing houses, bark from the debarking machines in the pulp and paper mills, fruit peelings and fruit rinds from fruit canning and packing industry, and generally in industries where good housekeeping practices are not followed. Micro screenings may also be used for complete removal of suspended impurities so as to eliminate primary sedimentation. Screens may be coarse, medium or fine depending on the clear space between the bars. So here we can see the medium screen in figure. Fine screens may be rotary drum type, tangential type or vibratory type. Screens are manually or mechanically cleaned. In any case, adequate arrangement must be made to treat and dispose of the screen material. Second is sedimentation. In sedimentation, removal of finely suspended and settleable solid is done. By plain sedimentation, while chemically aerated sedimentation is required for removal of colloidal solids. So question arises, what are colloidal solids? So colloids are the particles which are very small, soluble or insoluble in liquid and have very small size and range from 1 to 1000 nanometer in diameter. So here we can see that as the time passes, the amount of sludge that settles becomes less and less. Now we will go for the flotation. So flotation may be termed as negative sedimentation. It is done to remove impurities which are lighter than water and do not settle in a reasonable length of time, like coagulants. In sedimentation, flotation may be done with or without the aid of flotation agents. Industries employing sedimentation include almost all those producing high suspended organic and inorganic solids, which flotation is particularly useful in woolen mills, स्लॉटर हाउसेस, पल्प एंड पेपर मिल्स, ऑयल रिफाइनरीज एंड डेरीज। बोथ सेडिमेंटेशन एंड फ्लोटेशन हेल्प्स टू रिड्यूस द सॉलिड लोड ऑन द फॉलोइंग ट्रीटमेंट यूनिट्स। हायर फ्लोटेशन इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द रिकवरी ऑफ यूजफुल मटेरियल फ्रॉम द वेस्ट स्ट्रीम्स। सो इन फ्लोटेशन द लाइटर पार्टिकल्स विच डू नॉट गेट सेटल, द पार्टिकल्स विच आर लाइटर दैन द वॉटर एंड विच डू नॉट गेट सेटल इन रिजनेबल लेंथ ऑफ टाइम, फॉर दैट पार्टिकल्स द फ्लोटेशन इज यूज। In the figure, there is the sedimentation tank and primary sediment tank is given. In this, the water coagulants are added, and and it is rotated by rotary flow. The coagulants mix up the particles and they are collected below. Next comes the filtration. Filtration of industrial wastewater is more often practiced downstream of other pretreatment processes than as a standalone pretreatment method. So filtration is not used alone. It is used along with the different pretreatment processes. It is used during neutralization or precipitation of heavy metals and biological treatment to reduce biological oxygen demand loads. It may also be used to remove lime precipitates or phosphates and as a pretreatment for wastewater before it is discharged to an activated carbon column or to a dialysis or reverse osmosis unit. In reuse applications, filtration is used if the treated wastewater is to be sprayed on land for irrigation, groundwater injection, lawn sprinkling, and body contact recreational uses. This is the example of the rapid sand filter. The water is allowed from the valve 1. This allows effluent to flow to filter. Second, open valve 2. This allows water to flow through the filter. Third valve, during filter operation, all other valves are closed. So the open valve 1 allows the effluent to enter to the filter. It goes through sand and gravel and some impurities are removed from it. During the operations, all the valves are closed. All the other valves are closed. From the valve 2, the water is allowed to go from the filter. So next is mixing. Mixing is an important unit operation in wastewater treatment. It is used for mixing of one substance with another. Example, chlorine or sodium hypochlorite with treated wastewater. Liquid suspension such as in the aeration tank of activated sludge process or sludge undergoing aerobic or anaerobic digestion. For flocculation of finely divided suspended solids with coagulants, for heat transfer as in heated digesters, and for mixing neutralizing chemicals with acidic or alkaline waste streams. Continuous rapid mixing is achieved by providing baffles or hydraulic jumps in open channels, by fixing static mixers or venturi flumes in pipelines. Continuous mixing is achieved by pumping the tank contents and recycling a part of the pumped liquid by using mechanical mixers or with the help of compressed air bubbled into the liquid. Compressed air and mechanical mixers also serve the purpose of maintaining the tank contents in a fresh condition. So to maintain the tank contents in fresh condition, the mechanical mixer and the compressed air is used. If the wastewater contains oily and greasy matter, compressed air helps float a part of this matter which can be skimmed off. Mixing helps in giving partial treatment to wastewater streams of opposite nature. Example, mutual neutralization of acidic and alkaline effluents or partial cooling of hot streams when mixed with cold streams. Wastewater streams which are highly fluctuating in their quality and flow rates are best handled by mixing them in equalization tanks. So this is the example of mechanical mixer, which is single blade. Mechanical mixer rotates and mixes the coagulant feed with the effluent so that the particles of the effluents get mixed up or get attached to each other to increase their weight so that they can be they get collected. So next comes the equalization. Equalization means it is the process of controlling hydraulic velocity or flow rate through a wastewater treatment system. The equalization of flow prevents short-term high volumes of incoming cold surges from forcing solids and organic material out of the treatment process. The effluent to an industrial wastewater treatment varies in flow and concentration of pollutants because the discharges from the manufacturing and utility processes are not constant. So therefore the equalization tank is used. Also, equalization is used to overcome the operational problems caused by variations in quality and flow rates to improve the performance of downstream processes and to reduce the size and cost of downstream units of treatment. Equalization helps dilute toxic pollutants. It is also an attractive proposition for upgrading the performance of an overloaded treatment plant. Equalization can be done inline or offline. The former is done when equalization of plant loading is desired, means inline equalization is used when the equalization of plant loading is desired, and offline equalization is used when the downstream treatment units, especially biological units, are to be protected against shock loads due to slugs of toxic and or organic pollutants. An essential requirement of an equalization basin is adequate mixing of the basin contents. This ensures a more or less uniform quality of the outflow, minimizes chances of deposition of solids in the basin, and helps keep the wastewater fresh. So if the adequate mixing of the basin contents is provided in the equalization tank, then there will be more uniform quality of the outflow, and it will minimize the deposition of the solids in the basin and helps keep the wastewater fresh. This is the equalization tank diagram, picture of the equalization tank. So you can see the mixers provided in the equalization tanks. This is the diagram of inline equalization basin, and second is sideline equalization basin. So inline equalization basin, the equalization tank is provided in the line only, and in sideline equalization basin it is provided at the side. Next comes the flow proportioning. Flow proportioning is not strictly speaking a unit operation, but can be used in conjunction with the equalization. Means conjunction means flow proportioning can be connected with the equalization tank. It consists of storing a wastewater stream in a tank of suitable size and discharging it into other streams, either domestic sewage or industrial wastes, in proportion to the flow in the receiving wastewater stream, so that the mixture does not exert an unduly high organic, hydraulic, toxic load on the receiving body of the water or the wastewater treatment plant. Means that means the water stream from the inner tank of the flow proportioning is allowed with the high flow in the receiving wastewater stream if the receiving wastewater stream is flowing with the high velocity, and if the water stream from the flow proportioning is allowed in the receiving wastewater with the less velocity if the receiving wastewater stream is having the less flow. This method is useful in dealing with toxic waste or waste having a high oxygen demand. So our next is drying. Drying and incineration are almost exclusively used for handling waste water sludges generated during the various sludges generated during the various treatment processes. So question arises, what is sludges? So sludge is a thick, soft, unpleasant substance. Drying is done to get rid of a large fraction of the moisture entrained with the sludge solids and to reduce its volume. This is done by spreading the sludge in a layer ranging in a thickness from 20 cm to 30 cm on sand drying beds. A part of the moisture evaporates and the rest percolates through the sand and gravel layers of the drying beds. This filtrate is recycled to the plant inlet. Sludge so dried can be removed from the beds when its moisture contents are reduced to between 50% and 55%. If the space for constructing the beds is inadequate, mechanical means such as vacuum filtration, centrifugation, plate and frame presses or belt filters are employed.